Welcome to a day in my life.
Charm of eating it is right here in the restaurant when it's nice and steaming hot and fresh. This is turning out to be another evening of Lukhagiri. I'm getting inside a store for some shopping after over a year, and I just thought of taking you guys with me. Come on! I've literally just come to the trial room to show you this, and I don't think I'm going to be trying it because I'm confident that these will fit me. So this is one t-shirt that I'm getting, and this is another top that I'm getting. Since I've gotten out today, I thought might as well head over to one of my most favorite restaurants in the city, and I'm coming to Swati Snacks after such a long gap. I remember coming here almost every week, every 2 weeks, and this is like a place that my husband and I absolutely love. I have ordered from here during the lockdown but haven't visited, so since I'm in this area, I thought of coming down here. There are two locations of Swati Snacks. One is Tardeo, the other is Nariman Point. I'm at the Tardeo one, and I've ordered a dish which I absolutely love here. It is pumpkin chutney and sugarcane juice, and the sugarcane juice is here. And let me just say this, I love sugarcane juice. Like, I love it at various spots in the city, but the sugarcane juice at Swati is just something else. They put such a lot of ginger in it and such a lot of lime in it, and it is super duper refreshing. This feels good. Trust me, I can chug this entire thing in one go, but I think I'm just gonna wait patiently for my pumpki to come. Pumpki is a very healthy dish, to be honest. It is a steamed dish. It comes in this leaf, and it's like a rice pancake, and it is so flavorful. So you can see how the batter is steamed between two banana leaves. And it's really, really thin. It's a very light dish, but a very fulfilling dish. And they serve it with chutney and a little bit of pickle. I think it's pickle. But this is something that I have to always, always eat whenever I'm at Swati. And it's super, super thin. Like, you can see it's really thin and delicate. Charm of eating it is right here in the restaurant when it's nice and steaming hot and fresh. Honestly, I don't need any chutney or anything with it, but they do give a little bit on the side, and it just adds to the flavor, so I've just dipped into some. Wow, now this whole afternoon evening out is feeling worthwhile. This is a dry chili pickle that they give, and I do find it a little bit spicy, so I don't end up having this. Even their chutney is on the spicier side. It's got little bits of coriander in between, and they have different flavors of pumpki. So there is a fudina pumpki, there is a dill flavored pumpki, but I just like the plain classic one. I did actually make a video on Swati Snacks, I think many years ago. I'm going to leave a link to that in the description box below, but it's still a place that I visit very often. If you're looking for good Gujarati food in Mumbai, then Swati Snacks is one of the best options. Right outside Swati is this guy who sells the most amazing sauf and churan, and I'm going to be going and getting some from there. I just don't know whether I'm going to be able to film that, so I thought of showing it to you guys from here. You can see the range of things that you get here. Sauf, supari, seeds, paan. This is imli candy. I love it. This is Tikha Kerry. It's gonna make your mouth water. This is the range of seeds. Pumpkin seed, melon seed, sunflower seed, till. Ye roast kiye hue hai. And different types of sauv. And this is a hing peda. This is anardana goli. This is jeera goli. I like all of these. This is dry paan. Wow. And I'll show you my favorite item here. It is this. This is meetha masala. I think that's what it's called. And this is almost like a paan but without the leaf. So I usually end up getting this from here and a couple of these other things. Aur ye aapne pack kar diya? Anardana ka goli pack kar dijiye. So whenever you're at Swati Snacks, just head outside. This is the Swati Snacks at Tardeo and head to Arun's stall and enjoy all of these delicious goodies here. So this is my pack. So that there is the Oberoi, and this is the Trident, and we are at Nariman Point. I haven't come here in like forever and this is feeling so good. Very, very strict about wearing a mask here, so I'm not taking that off, but feeling outside at this time is feeling amazing. And I actually wanted to do this when I'm filming a vlog like this, because last time I went to Chowpatty, you guys enjoyed it quite a bit. Is turning out to be another evening of Lukhagiri. I feel like having Kerry so badly, but I just don't think I should right now. This whole video is going to be a video of firsts. So the first time I've entered a physical shopping store after this entire lockdown bit. The first time I'm going to one of my favorite restaurant, Gujarati food restaurant in Mumbai. And the first time I'm chilling at Nariman Point in over a year. Definitely going to be a while until the sunset and I really need to head home, but I just don't feel like letting go of this view. Just look at the sparkling water. Gorgeous, right? For dinner, I wanted to keep it really, really simple, and this is kind of a dish that takes care of cravings as well and is pretty much mostly on the healthier side, except for that one dollop of butter that goes in making it. You can totally replace it with oil, but with butter, butter chana is complete. So first butter, then I saute some onions, and you can leave them kind of like a little crunchy or cook them all the way, depends however you like it. And once it's done, I add some chopped tomatoes. Bhuno the tomatoes nicely, make sure they're nice and mushy. And then I also add some boiled potatoes and finally chana. Now in this, you can technically use kabuli chana, black chana, which is what I'm using, or even green chana. And all of these have their own subtle flavor and they all taste good. So add that in and then add whatever spices you like. My personal favorites are red chili powder, pav bhaji masala, chaat masala, and I also add a bit of lime, rock salt, and then this is ready. So this is a super simple but a super duper satisfying dish, and it's a street style dinner. I would say a healthier street style recipe that can be done very, very easily at home.
and it feels good.
This is all the shopping that I did today. I just thought I'll show it to you guys. I ended up getting these scrunchies. These are the thinner ones. They're the silky ones. I don't know whether it's good silk or not, but I wanted these slightly thinner ones, so I got these. These cost me $3.99 for 1, 2, 3, 4 of them. I think it's a bit expensive, but I thought they were good quality.
Then I got this animal print blouse. I didn't go to any other place today apart from H&M, and this one I actually quite liked. It was at 50% off, so actually not 50, a little bit lesser. This cost me 1,000 rupees, and it is a little dressy, a little bit more formal, like I could wear it to a nice-ish place. So I think this was nice. It's got this neck detailing and a similar detailing on the sleeves as well. And I got a t-shirt which says it's okay, and I hope it is soon going to be okay. And this I got on full price, 800 rupees, but I do like the fabric. It's not too thin, like it's not see-through at all. It's a nice soft yet thickish fabric. Is all from Outside Swati Snacks. So this is that nice meetha masala, and I got 4 of these, and I got anardana goli. So yeah, this is my shopping from today. Happiness is a dessert from Theo's.
Fresh pineapple pastry. This is what I think I'm gonna have. Then we have a Dutch truffle pastry. I absolutely love their Dutch truffle. It is dark, it is really rich. And then I have some walnut brownies. These are eggless brownies. Both of these pastries are also eggless. The good thing I like about Theo's is whatever they have in their menu with egg, they have the exact same variety in eggless as well.
I love a good pineapple pastry. Are you guys fond of fruit-based pastries like a fresh pineapple, a fresh strawberry? Let me know in the comments, because I kind of like them. Chocolate is pretty evergreen, like you can have it anytime, but a fresh cream pastry with fruit, something that at least I need to be in the mood for. I'm gonna finish the rest of my pastry, and I hope you enjoyed this video. It was such an impromptu vlog, which I started filming in the evening as my day got a bit more interesting. And I think it's been a great day. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, then you know what you have to do. Hit that like button, share this video with all of your friends and family, and subscribe to my channel. And let me know in the comments below if you'd like to see more such vlogs. Also give me some vlog ideas and topics so that I can keep making them more and more. And I'll wait for your comments, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.